Well, our next guest is one of the richest self-made women in Australia. She's also on Shark Tank, the 10 TV show that is making dreams come true for budding entrepreneurs. Let's welcome Janine Allis to Studio 10. It's so lovely to have you on our panel, finally. You've just been announced as one of Australia's 30 richest self-made women. Amazing.
Wow. Who would have thought that?
Got any tips for us?
I work really hard.
Get a good idea.
Yeah, good idea and find passion. I think that to really be successful, you do have to give your soul to it. Mm. And I think that if you can find something that you love, then it's not work.
Mm. Yeah, and also if it's something you don't love, you're simply not going to work hard enough you need to make it happen, because to make it happen, you basically have to work 24/7.
Yeah, well, look, I started thinking, because I had three children at the time, I still had one child on the breast, and I went, I want to have balance. Yeah. And stupidly, I thought business was the way to do it. But no, that wasn't the case.
I remember you saying in one of the pictures that you didn't know how to balance books or anything like that.
No,
you
had
to teach yourself everything.
Yeah, my business. Oh, look, I left school at 16. I went to a tech school, so I'm really good at building woodwork, and I can type fast. But I, don't ask me anything about geography or history or anything. And you'll notice on the Shark Tank, I went, what's that Chinese? Japanese. So, coming from a very low base.
But you've done well with geography now, because you've got Boost Juice outlets all over the world.
Correct. Yeah. And I do now know where Estonia is, which I didn't know before. So,
is Boost Juice big in Estonia, is it?
Massive.
Wow. Amazing.
Big in Estonia. Wow.
$2 billion worth of sales. 300 stores.
Not bad,
doing all right.
Yeah. No, look, we started actually, we have a vision, wouldn't it be good if, and the growth in obesity was really in line with the growth of fast food chains. And I thought, well, if I can create a product that actually helps to achieve people making healthy easy, then I've done my job.
Yeah. What about Shark Tank, though? All those very timid people coming to pitch their ideas at you. But you've been one of the biggest investors, which I've loved. Mm. I'm really wanting Andrew to invest. Why isn't he investing that much?
Oh, just that I'm competitive. I like to win.
Yeah, you like to win. I can see it in your eyes.
I want that off him. Oh, look, I think different people. I think we pretty much did sort of similar sort of deals and or quantity of deals. And I think just different people appeal to, like the food ones, I went, right, I really understand that. And sometimes you know too much. It's like if you're in the industry that you're sort of specialised in, you go, oh, mate, that's hard,
But they all seem to have the one big problem, though, getting more money, isn't it? It's always getting the money, because they're small business, so small business never has much fat in the bank or anything, and banks don't always want to invest in you either.
No, they don't. We have to sell our home to put our money in. Yeah. So, but you're right. But you look for that X factor. You're looking for that. That something in their eyes, and you just watch Scrubber, and he had that. He just knew it. He was, and you just go, yep. And you quite often invest in the person, and the rest will come, because it's a long journey.
And that was the bloke who had a portable washing machine, basically a bag that would wash clothes on trips. We saw an amazing pitch on Sunday, the Hummingbirds Early Intervention and Education
Centre. Glad you mentioned this. You know what I really liked about this? It was incredibly beautiful. It was these two women here, you can see them there. They wanted to open up a childcare centre for kids with special needs, with disabilities. And the thing that really impressed me, I thought, well, all the sharks are just going to be falling all over themselves to just throw money at it, because it's such a good look. But you're actually tough. And the two women sharks said, actually, you look, love your work, but I'm not going to put my money there. And it was the real gruff, tough guy shark, Steve Baxter, said, well, you know what? Here you go, you can have a bit of money. And then, of course, John McGrath got on board. Yeah. But it's not...
And was reduced to tears.
And was reduced to tears when he was talking about childcare centres. But that it's a tough show. It's not a show where everyone gets together at the end and has a group hug and says, oh, that's so inspirational. Like, it's a show where you've got to stand on your merit.
Totally. It's not a game show. It's an investment show. Yeah. And, if it was about charities, then that's a bit different. But the thing I liked about the girls is it was actually a real business.
Mm, absolutely.
And the thing, though, that when I was sitting there and I was going, don't I? But I knew that they needed that hands-on. And Steve's, like, a kilometre away from them. So he was the perfect partner. So as soon as he went in, I went, right, they've got the partners. Yeah. And, we'll support in other ways where we can. I mean, I know that Steve's done a couple of deals, and I've met probably more of his deals helping them in their area. career. So we just, we all kind of collaborate and go, right, how do we collectively make it? Because it's, you know, it's tough starting a business. As you said, the cash you need, it just burns cash.
Just smash the stereotypes. That's what I really liked about it, and constantly surprise you.
And Janine, you are such a joy to watch. You're so inspirational and accessible as well. We will see you Sunday night, 7:30, right here on 10 for Shark Tank. Don't miss it.